Hello there, Geoff Carter here, and today we're cooking with Carter, live from Carter's Kitchen. And today I thought I'd make you one of the famous curries from Thailand. It's called Panang Gai. Right then, let's get started. First of all, we'll chop some green beans into, you know, about 2-inch pieces. And then we will chop a chilli. Just chop it into like diagonal slices. Some's for decoration and some's to make the Panang Gai have a bit of a kick to it. If you don't like it too hot, then just take the seeds out. And here we've got some kaffir lime leaves. And basically, just rip them ones up. Just rip them up and take that middle vein bit out. You don't want that. Just gives it a nice limey taste. Kaffir lime leaves, there you go. And then two more for decoration. And what I suggest you do is you wrap them up like this tightly. Like that, you see? Like that. And then just simply slice as thinly as you can. Watch your fingers. And this will do for decoration later in the cooking thing. Okay. Now what you want to do is get your chicken. Cut it into a couple of strips like that. And this is the trick with Thailand food. Slice diagonally thin like that on an angle. See? And what it does, it makes your chicken go further. And it cooks faster. Like Chinese is like chunks of chicken, isn't it? This is slithers. Just take your blade and slice diagonally. Watch your fingers. And that is your chicken sliced. Just diagonally like that. Nice motion. Nice and thin. And away you go. Okay, the wok's warming up nicely now. Add 2 tablespoons full of oil, and then 1 tablespoon of Panang curry paste, and we want to just fry this off now, only on a medium heat, not a red hot heat yet, and just let it infuse with the oil. There we go. Right, 1/4 cup of coconut milk. I said coconut milk then, didn't I? It gets to you this, but this is all the flavours you see when you add them to the pan. And that's nice there now. And just let that bubble away for a moment. Okay, that's doing nicely now. So now we're going to add the sugar, 2 tablespoons full of sugar. Two sprigs of green peppercorns. Some baby aubergines, there they are. They pop in your mouth. Two cloves of garlic chopped. And then we're going to turn up the heat now. And we're going to add the rest of the tin of coconut milk. Let that bubble away now. Now we add the red chilli peppers, kaffir lime leaves, and the green beans. Finally, a little glug of fish sauce. Some basil leaves. If you can get only basil leaves, they're the best ones. But if you can only get normal basil leaves, they'll do. A nice handful of basil leaves in there now. You can hear it sizzling, beautiful. Wow. Couple more. Break them up. And now what we're going to do is reduce this down now before we add the chicken. Right, while that's reducing down, I'll tell you where I got this idea from. When I was in Chiang Mai in Thailand, I was just walking along the moat and it started to rain. So I went in this little place called John's Place. Some of you might know about it. Anyway, I sat down and had a bottle of beer and I felt a bit hungry. And I said, "What's your best curry, love?" And she said, "Panang Gai. We make the best in Thailand." I said, "Go on then." It come, and I'm not joking, it was absolutely fantastic. 6 years later, I've had Panang Gai in about another 100 places. Never, ever, ever beat it. So if you're ever in Chiang Mai, look for John's Place. And I tell you something, that's what made me make this today for you. Dead easy to make. Really easy ingredients. And now what we're going to do, we're going to add the chicken just to poach. And then we're ready to serve up. Okay? The smells are fantastic coming off this. And as you can see, it's reducing down now. And what you do, you just add your chicken. You don't fry it. This, because it's dead thin, it just poaches. Look at that. Delicious. And as you can see already, the chicken's turning white. It's nearly cooked. You don't want to overcook it, you see. Because if you do, the chicken's not tender. It becomes tough. So just move it round. And then it'll soak up all them beautiful taste. Wow. Fantastic. Okay. So we get the rice now. And you put it on the plate like this. Turn it upside down. Ta-da! Nice steaming white rice. Now we get the Panang Gai. And we put it in slowly like this. Ooh, look at that. Absolutely gorgeous. Smells absolutely wonderful. And then grab just a little bit more. Look at that. Ooh, chilies, peppercorns, chicken. Ooh, and the juice just flows into the rice. Mouth-watering. Then just get a little bit more cream on the top there, coconut cream, lovely. And then some chilies, sprinkle them on. And then finally, just sprinkle it with a little bit of the kaffir lime leaves, and there you have it. Ladies and gentlemen, Panang Gai. Wow. Fantastic. Why not have a go at making this yourselves? As you see, it was so easy to make. Mm-hmm. Delicious. So, that's show one of Cooking with Carter. Wow, crunchy, popping in your mouth, fantastic. Stay tuned because we'll be doing more cooking shows coming soon. And don't forget, if you want the recipe, all the details will be down below, and give us a thumbs up and tell us where I've gone wrong, because it was only my first go and I'm doing it on my own. I haven't got a camera crew or anything. But I've enjoyed cooking for you. So, it's goodbye from Geoff Carter, Cooking with Carter in Carter's Kitchen. See you again. Bye-bye now.